Listen, 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 listen. Perhaps you catch a hint of an ancient state, not quite forgotten. Dim, perhaps, and yet not altogether unfamiliar. Like a song whose name is long forgotten, and the circumstances in which you heard completely unremembered. Not the whole song has stayed with you, but just a little wisp of melody, attached not to a person or a place or anything particular, but you remember from just this little part how lovely was the song, how wonderful the setting where you heard it, and how you loved those who were there and listened with you. The notes are nothing, yet you have kept them with you, not for themselves, but as a soft reminder of what would make you weep if you remembered how dear it was to you. You could remember, yet you are afraid, believing you would lose the world you learned since then. And yet, you know that nothing in the world you learned is half so dear as this. Listen, and see if you remember an ancient song you knew so long ago and held more dear than any melody you taught yourself to cherish since. The thoughts of God are far beyond all change and shine forever. They await not birth, they wait for welcome and remembering. The thought God holds of you is like a star, unchangeable in an eternal sky. So high in heaven is it set that those outside of heaven know not it is there. Yet still and white and lovely, will it shine through all eternity? There was no time it was not there, no instant when its light grew dimmer or less perfect ever was. Who knows the Father knows this light, for he is the eternal sky that holds it safe, forever lifted up and anchored sure. Its perfect purity does not depend on whether it is seen on earth or not. The sky embraces it and softly holds it in its perfect place, which is as far from earth as earth from heaven. It is not the distance nor the time that keeps this star invisible to earth, but those who seek for idols cannot know the star is there. Beyond all idols is the thought God holds of you, completely unaffected by the turmoil and the terror of the world, the dreams of birth and death that here are dreamed, the myriad of forms that fear can take. Quite undisturbed, the thought God holds of you remains exactly as it always was. Surrounded by a stillness so complete, no sound of battle comes remotely near. It rests in certainty and perfect peace. Where could the thought God holds of you exist but where you are? You have not two realities, but one. Nor can you be aware of more than one. An idol, or the thought God holds of you, is your reality. Forget not, then, that idols must keep hidden what you are, not from the mind of God, but from your own. The star shines still, the sky has never changed. But you, the holy Son of God himself, are unaware of your reality. This world you seem to live in is not home to you. And somewhere in your mind, you know that this is true. Memory of home keeps haunting you, as if there were a place that called you to return, although you do not recognize the voice, nor what it is the voice reminds you of. Yet still you feel an alien here, from somewhere all unknown. Nothing so definite that you could say with certainty you are an exile here. Just a persistent feeling, sometimes not more than a tiny throb, at other times hardly remembered, actively dismissed, but surely to return to mind again. No one but knows whereof we speak, yet some try to put by their suffering in games they play to occupy their time and keep their sadness from them. Others will deny that they are sad and do not recognize their tears at all. Still, others will maintain that what we speak of is illusion, not to be considered more than but a dream. Yet who, in simple honesty, without defensiveness and self-deception, would deny he understands the words we speak? We speak today for everyone who walks this world, for he is not at home. He goes uncertainly about in endless search, seeking in darkness what he cannot find, not recognizing what it is he seeks. Here is the only home he thinks he knows. Here is the only safety he believes that he can find. Without the world he made, is he an outcast, homeless and afraid? He does not realize that it is here he is afraid indeed, and homeless too. An outcast wandering so far from home, so long away, he does not realize he has forgotten where he came from, where he goes, and even who he really is. Yet in his lonely, senseless wanderings, God's gifts go with him, all unknown to him. He cannot lose them. Still, he wanders on, in misery and poverty, alone, though God is with him. And a treasure his so great that everything the world contains is valueless before its magnitude. He seems a sorry figure, weary, worn, in threadbare clothing, and with feet that bleed a little from the rocky road he walks. No one but has identified with him, for everyone who comes here has pursued the path he follows and has felt defeat and hopelessness as he is feeling them. Yet, is he really tragic when you see that he is following the way he chose and need but realize who walks with him and open up his treasures to be free? Perhaps you think it is your childhood home that you would find again, the childhood of your body and its place of shelter are a memory now so distorted that you merely hold a picture of a past that never happened. Yet there is a child in you who seeks his father's house and knows that he is alien here. This childhood is eternal, with an innocence that will endure forever. Where this child shall go is holy ground. It is his holiness that lights up heaven and that brings to earth the pure reflection of the light above, wherein are earth and heaven joined as one. It is this child in you your father knows as his own son. It is this child who knows his father. He desires to go home so deeply, so unceasingly. His voice cries unto you to let him rest a while. He does not ask for more than just a few instants of respite. Just an interval in which he can return to breathe again the holy air that fills his father's house. You are his home as well. He will return. But give him just a little time to be himself within the peace that is his home, resting in silence and in peace and love. This child needs your protection. He is far from home. He is so little that he seems so easily shut out. His tiny voice so readily obscured. His call for help almost unheard amid the grating sounds and harsh and rasping noises of the world. Yet does he know that in you still abides his sure protection? You will fail him not. He will go home, and you along with him. When you are still an instant, when the world recedes from you, when valueless ideas cease to have value in your restless mind, then will you hear his voice. So poignantly he calls to you that you will not resist him longer. In that instant, he will take you to his home, and you will stay with him in perfect stillness, silent and at peace, beyond all words, untouched by fear and doubt, sublimely certain that you are at home. Swear not to die, you holy Son of God. You make a bargain that you cannot keep. The Son of Life cannot be killed. He is immortal as his Father. What he is cannot be changed. He is the only thing in all the universe that must be one. What seems eternal, all will have an end. The stars will disappear, and night and day will be no more. All things that come and go, the tides, the seasons, and the lives of men, all things that change with time and bloom and fade, will not return. Where time has set an end is not where the eternal is. God's Son can never change by what men made of him. He will be as he was and as he is, for time appointed not his destiny, nor set the hour of his birth and death. Forgiveness will not change him, yet time waits upon forgiveness, that the things of time may disappear, because they have no use. You are the dreamer of the world of dreams. No other cause it has, nor ever will. Nothing more fearful than an idle dream has terrified God's Son and made him think that he has lost his innocence, denied his Father, and made war upon himself. So fearful is the dream, so seeming real, he could not waken to reality without the sweat of terror and a scream of mortal fear. Unless a gentler dream preceded his wakening and allowed his calmer mind to welcome, not to fear, the voice that calls with love to waken him. God willed he waken gently and with joy, and gave him means to waken without fear. Accept the dream he gave instead of yours. It is not difficult to change a dream when once the dreamer has been recognized. Rest in the Holy Spirit and allow his gentle dreams to take the place of those you dreamed in terror and in fear of death. He brings forgiving dreams in which the choice is not who is the murderer and who shall be the victim. In the dreams he brings, there is no murder and there is no death. The dream of guilt is fading from your sight. Although your eyes are closed, a smile has come to lighten up your sleeping face. The sleep is peaceful now, for these are happy dreams. Dream softly of your sinless brother, who unites with you in holy innocence. And from this dream, the Lord of heaven will himself awaken his beloved son. Dream of your brother's kindness, instead of dwelling in your dreams on his mistakes. Select his thoughtfulness to dream about, instead of counting up the hurts he gave. Forgive him his illusions, and give thanks to him for all the helpfulness he gave. And do not brush aside his many gifts, because he is not perfect in your dreams. Let all your brother's gifts be seen in light of charity and kindness offered you. And let no pain disturb your dream of deep appreciation for his gifts to you. What could you want forgiveness cannot give? Do you want peace? Forgiveness offers it. Do you want happiness, a quiet mind, a certainty of purpose, and a sense of worth and beauty that transcends the world? Do you want care and safety, and the warmth of sure protection always? Do you want a quietness that cannot be disturbed, a gentleness that never can be hurt, a deep, abiding comfort, and a rest so perfect it can never be upset? All this forgiveness offers you, and more. It sparkles on your eyes as you awake and gives you joy with which to meet the day. It soothes your forehead while you sleep and rests upon your eyelids so you see no dreams of fear and evil, malice and attack. And when you wake again, it offers you another day of happiness and peace. All this forgiveness offers you, and more. God's plan for your salvation cannot change, nor can it fail. Be thankful it remains exactly as he planned it. Changelessly, it stands before you like an open door, with warmth and welcome, calling from beyond the doorway, bidding you to enter in and make yourself at home where you belong. Here is the answer. Would you stand outside while all of heaven waits for you within? Forgive and be forgiven. As you give, you will receive. There is no plan but this, for the salvation of the Son of God. Let us today rejoice that this is so, for here we have an answer clear and plain, beyond deceit in its simplicity. All the complexities the world has spun of fragile cobwebs disappear before the power and the majesty of this extremely simple statement of the truth. Here is the answer. Do not turn away in aimless wandering again. Accept salvation now. It is the gift of God and not the world. Open your eyes today and look upon a happy world of safety and of peace. Forgiveness is the means by which it comes to take the place of hell. In quietness, it rises up to greet your open eyes and fill your heart with deep tranquility. As ancient truth, forever newly born, arise in your awareness. What you will remember then can never be described. Yet your forgiveness offers it to you. Seek you no further. You will not find peace except the peace of God. Accept this fact and save yourself the agony of yet more bitter disappointments, bleak despair, and sense of icy hopelessness and doubt. Seek you no further. There is nothing else for you to find except the peace of God, unless you seek for misery and pain. Come home. You have not found your happiness in foreign places and in alien forms that have no meaning to you, though you sought to make them meaningful. This world is not where you belong. You are a stranger here, but it is given you to find the means whereby the world no longer seems to be a prison house or jail for anyone. Peace is the bridge that everyone will cross to leave this world behind. But peace begins within the world perceived as different, and leading from this fresh perception to the gate of heaven and the way beyond. Peace is the answer to conflicting goals, to senseless journeys, frantic, vain pursuits, and meaningless endeavors. Now the way is easy, sloping gently toward the bridge where freedom lies within the peace of God. Let us not lose our way again today. We go to heaven, and the path is straight. Only if we attempt to wander can there be delay and needless wasted time on thorny byways. God alone is sure, and He will guide our footsteps. He will not desert his son in need, nor let him stray forever from his home. The father calls, the son will hear. And that is all there is to what appears to be a world apart from God, where bodies have reality. Now is there silence. Seek no further. You have come to where the road is carpeted with leaves of false desires, fallen from the trees of hopelessness you sought before. Now are they underfoot, and you look up and on toward heaven, with the body's eyes but serving for an instant longer now. Peace is already recognized at last, and you can feel its soft embrace surround your heart and mind with comfort and with love. Be glad today how very easily is hell undone. You need but tell yourself, I am the Holy Son of God Himself. I cannot suffer, cannot be in pain. I cannot suffer loss, nor fail to do all that salvation asks. And in that thought is everything you look on, wholly changed. A miracle has lighted up all dark and ancient caverns where the rites of death echoed since time began. For time has lost its hold upon the world. The Son of God has come in glory to redeem the lost, to save the helpless, and to give the world the gift of his forgiveness. Who could see the world as dark and sinful when God's Son has come again at last to set it free? You who perceive yourself as weak and frail, with futile hopes and devastated dreams, born but to die, to weep and suffer pain, hear this. All power is given unto you in earth and heaven. There is nothing that you cannot do. You play the game of death, of being helpless, pitifully tied to dissolution in a world which shows no mercy to you. Yet, when you accord it mercy, will its mercy shine on you? Then let the Son of God awaken from his sleep, and opening his holy eyes, return again to bless the world he made. In error it began, but it will end in the reflection of his holiness. And he will sleep no more and dream of death. Then join with me today. Your glory is the light that saves the world. Do not withhold salvation longer. Look about the world and see the suffering there. Is not your heart willing to bring your weary brothers rest? They must await your own release. They stay in chains till you are free. They cannot see the mercy of the world until you find it in yourself. They suffer pain until you have denied its hold on you. They die till you accept your own eternal life. You are the Holy Son of God Himself. Remember this, and all the world is free. Remember this, and earth and heaven are one. Forget not once this journey is begun, the end is certain. Doubt along the way will come and go to come again. Yet is the ending sure? No one can fail to do what God appointed him to do. When you forget, remember that you walk with him and with his word upon your heart. The end is sure and guaranteed by God. Who stands before a lifeless image when a step away, the Holy of the Holies opens up an ancient door that leads beyond the world? You are a stranger here, but you belong to him who loves you as he loves himself. Ask but my help to roll the stone away, and it is done according to his will. We have begun the journey. Long ago, the end was written in the stars and set into the heavens with a shining ray that held it safe within eternity and through all time as well, and holds it still, unchanged, unchanging, and unchangeable. Be not afraid. We only start again, an ancient journey long ago begun, that but seems new. We have begun again, upon a road we traveled on before, and lost our way a little while. And now, we try again. Our new beginning has the certainty the journey lacked till now. Look up, and see his word among the stars, where he has set your name along with his. Look up, and find your certain destiny, the world would hide, but God would have you see. Let us wait here in silence, and kneel down an instant in our gratitude to him who called to us and helped us hear his call. And then, let us arise and go in faith along the way to him. Now, we are sure we do not walk alone, for God is here, and with him, all our brothers. Now we know that we will never lose the way again. The song begins again, which had stopped only an instant, though it seems to be unsung forever. What is here begun will grow in life and strength and hope until the world is still an instant and forgets all that the dream of sin had made of it. You maker of a world that is not so, take rest and comfort in another world where peace abides. This world you bring with you to all weary eyes and tired hearts that look on sin and beat its sad refrain. From you can come their rest. From you can rise a world they will rejoice to look upon, and where their hearts are glad. In you, there is a vision that extends to all of them and covers them in gentleness and light. And in this widening world of light, the darkness that they thought was there is pushed away until it is but distant shadows, far away, not long to be remembered, as the sun shines them to nothingness, and all their evil thoughts and sinful hopes, their dreams of guilt and merciless revenge, and every wish to hurt and kill and die, will disappear before the sun you bring. Would you not do this for the love of God and for yourself? For think what it would do for you. Your evil thoughts that haunt you now will seem increasingly remote and far away from you. And they go farther and farther off, because the sun in you has risen that they may be pushed away before the light. They linger for a while, a little while, in twisted forms too far away for recognition, and are gone forever. And in the sunlight, you will stand in quiet, in innocence, and wholly unafraid. And from you will the rest you found extend so that your peace can never fall away and leave you homeless. Those who offer peace to everyone have found a home in heaven the world cannot destroy, for it is large enough to hold the world within its peace. In you is all of heaven. Every leaf that falls is given life in you. Each bird that ever sang will sing again in you. And every flower that ever bloomed has saved its perfume and its loveliness for you. This can you bring to all the world and all the thoughts that entered it and were mistaken for a little while. How better could your own mistakes be brought to truth than by your willingness to bring the light of heaven with you as you walk beyond the world of darkness into light. There is a way of living in the world that is not here, although it seems to be. You do not change appearance, though you smile more frequently. Your forehead is serene, your eyes are quiet. And the ones who walk the world as you do recognize their own. Yet those who have not yet perceived the way will recognize you also, and believe that you are like them, as you were before. Illusion still appears to cling to you, that you may reach them, yet it has stepped back. And it is not illusion that they hear you speak of, nor illusion that you bring their eyes to look on and their minds to grasp. Nor can the truth which walks ahead of you speak to them through illusions, for the road leads past illusion now, while on the way you call to them that they may follow you. Walk safely now, yet carefully, because this path is new to you, and you may find that you are tempted still to walk ahead of truth and let illusions be your guide. Your holy brothers have been given you to follow in your footsteps as you walk with certainty of purpose to the truth. It goes before you now, that they may see something with which they can identify, something they understand to lead the way. Yet at the journey's ending, there will be no gap, no distance between truth and you, and all illusions, walking in the way you traveled, will be gone from you as well. With nothing left to keep the truth apart from God's completion, holy as Himself. Step back in faith, and let truth lead the way. You know not where you go, but one who knows goes with you. Let Him lead you with the rest. When dreams are over, time has closed the door on all the things that pass, and miracles are purposeless. The Holy Son of God will make no journeys. There will be no wish to be illusion rather than the truth. And we step forth toward this as we progress along the way that truth points out to us. This is our final journey, which we make for everyone. We must not lose our way, for as truth goes before us, so it goes before our brothers who will follow us. We walk to God. Pause and reflect on this. Could any way be holier or more deserving of your effort, of your love, and of your full intent? What way could give you more than everything, or offer less, and still content the Holy Son of God? We walk to God. Salvation can be thought of as a game that happy children play. It was designed by one who loves his children and who would replace their fearful toys with joyous games, which teach them that the game of fear is gone. His game instructs in happiness, because there is no loser. Everyone who plays must win, and in his winning is the gain to everyone insured. The game of fear is gladly laid aside when children come to see the benefits salvation brings. You who have played that you are lost to hope, abandoned by your father, left alone in terror, in a fearful world made mad by sin and guilt, be happy now. That game is over. Now a quiet time has come, in which we put away the toys of guilt and lock our quaint and childish thoughts of sin forever from the pure and holy minds of heaven's children and the Son of God. We pause, but for a moment more, to play our final happy game upon this earth. And then we go to take our rightful place, where truth abides and games are meaningless. Forgiveness turns the world of sin into a world of glory, wonderful to see. Each flower shines in light, and every bird sings of the joy of heaven. There is no sadness, and there is no parting here, for everything is totally forgiven. And what has been forgiven must join, for nothing stands between to keep them separate and apart. Who could fear love and stand upon the ground where sin has left a place for heaven's altar to rise and tower far above the world and reach beyond the universe to touch the heart of all creation? What is heaven but a song of gratitude and love and praise by everything created to the source of its creation? The holiest of altars is set where once sin was believed to be. And here does every light of heaven come to be rekindled and increased in joy. For here is what was lost restored to them, and all their radiance made whole again. Where sin once was perceived, will rise a world that will become an altar to the truth, and you will join the lights of heaven there and sing their song of gratitude and praise. And as they come to you to be complete, so will you go with them. For no one hears the song of heaven and remains without a voice that adds its power to the song and makes it sweeter still. And each one joins the singing at the altar that was raised within the tiny spot that sin proclaimed to be its own. And what was tiny then has soared into a magnitude of song in which the universe has joined with but a single voice. Here, the curriculum ends, From here on, no directions are needed. Vision is wholly corrected, and all mistakes undone. Attack is meaningless, and peace has come. The goal of the curriculum has been achieved. Thoughts turn to heaven and away from hell. All longings are satisfied. For what remains unanswered or incomplete? The last illusion spreads across the world, forgiving all things and replacing all attack. The whole reversal is accomplished. Nothing is left to contradict the word of God. There is no opposition to the truth. And now, the truth can come at last. How quickly will it come as it is asked to enter and envelop such a world? All living hearts are tranquil, with a stir of deep anticipation, for the time of everlasting things is now at hand. There is no death. The Son of God is free. And in his freedom is the end of fear. No hidden places now remain on earth to shelter sick illusions, dreams of fear, and misperceptions of the universe. All things are seen in light, and in the light, their purpose is transformed and understood. And we, God's children, rise up from the dust and look upon our perfect sinlessness. The song of heaven sounds round the world as it is lifted up and brought to truth. And now God's knowledge, changeless, certain, pure, and wholly understandable, enters its kingdom. Gone is perception, false and true alike. Gone is forgiveness, for its task is done. And gone are bodies in the blazing light upon the altar to the Son of God. God knows it is his own, as it is his. And here they join, for here the face of Christ has shown away time's final instant, and now is the last perception of the world, without a purpose, and without a cause. For where God's memory has come at last, there is no journey, no belief in sin, no walls, no bodies, and the grim appeal of guilt and death is there snuffed out forever. Oh, my brothers, if you only knew the peace that will envelop you and hold you safe and pure and lovely in the mind of God, you could but rush to meet him where his altar is. Hallowed your name and his, for they are joined here in this holy place. Here he leans down to lift you up to him, out of illusions into holiness, out of the world and to eternity, out of all fear and given back to love. All little things are silent. Little sounds are soundless now. The little things of earth have disappeared. The universe consists of nothing but the Son of God, who calls upon his Father and his Father's voice gives answer in his Father's holy name. In this eternal, still relationship, in which communication far transcends all words, and yet exceeds in depth and height whatever words could possibly convey, is peace eternal. Come unto me, my children, once again, without such twisted thoughts upon your hearts. You still are holy, with the holiness which fathered you in perfect sinlessness, and still surround you with the arms of peace. Dream now of healing. Then arise and lay all dreaming down forever. You are he your father loves, who never left his home, nor wandered in a savage world with feet that bleed and with a heavy heart made hard against the love that is the truth in you. Give all your dreams to Christ and let him be your guide to healing, leading you in prayer beyond the sorry reaches of the world. He comes for me and speaks my word to you. I would recall my weary son to me from dreams of malice to the sweet embrace of everlasting love and perfect peace. My arms are open to the son I love, who does not understand that he is healed and that his prayers have never ceased to sing his joyful thanks in unison with all creation in the holiness of love. Be still an instant. Underneath the sounds of harsh and bitter striving and defeat, there is a voice that speaks to you of me. Hear this an instant, and you will be healed. Hear this an instant, and you have been saved. Help me to wake my children from the dream of retribution and a little life beset with fear that in so soon it might as well have never been. Let me instead remind you of eternity, in which your joy grows greater as your love extends along with mine beyond infinity, where time and distance have no meaning. While you wait in sorrow, heaven's melody is incomplete, because your song is part of the eternal harmony of love. Without you is creation unfulfilled. Return to me who never left my son. Listen, my child, your father calls to you. Do not refuse to hear the call of love. Do not deny to Christ what is his own. Heaven is here, and heaven is your home. Creation leans across the bars of time to lift the heavy burden from the world. Lift up your hearts to greet its advent. See the shadows fade away in gentleness. The thorns fall softly from the bleeding brow of him who is the Holy Son of God. How lovely are you, child of holiness! How like to me! How lovingly I hold you in my heart and in my arms! How dear is every gift to me that you have made, who healed my son and took him from the cross! Arise, and let my thanks be given you. And with my gratitude will come the gift, first of forgiveness, then eternal peace. So now return your holy voice to me. The song of prayer is silent without you. The universe is waiting your release because it is its own. Be kind to it and to yourself, and then be kind to me. I ask but this, that you be comforted and live no more in terror and in pain. Do not abandon love. Remember this. Whatever you may think about yourself, whatever you may think about the world, your Father needs you and will call to you until you come to Him in peace at last.